it's finally done. Well, all that lay flow and elemental line stuff Lisa was going on about should hopefully be back to normal. Wanna go back and see how the knights are doing? But if you got anything more interesting to do, Paimon can come too. By the way, we obtained another animoculus in one of the Four Winds temples, right? We might come across more of them in the future, so don't forget to offer them to the statues.
You're in for a little shock. You're in for a little shock. You're in for a little shock.
And see if the gods respond. Feel the blessings of the seven? In Mondstadt. They can be fitted into the statue's eyes. Some stories say the statue's eyes originally had gems that were taken by swallows, but animalculi never had a physical form from the start. People with visions collect them to offer to the statues as blessings. You don't have a vision. But then the rules of this world don't apply to you anyway, so keep offering animalculi and maybe you'll receive more blessings.
Closer. Come a little closer.
Right. Welcome to the Adventurers Guild.
You've had your eye on her, eh? Has she been causing some mischief?
Oh, that is not what I meant at all. Being on the lookout for great adventurers is part of my job. When I look at you, I see one with the potential to rival the great adventurers of legends.
Paimon sees it too. Paimon always feels safe adventuring with her.
Nevertheless, to the adventurer, experience is far more precious than potential. You must accumulate adventurer experience to increase your adventure rank. Time is of the essence. Allow me to brief you on...
Wait, are you saying we're like official adventurers now?
Do not worry. The Adventurers Guild does not charge a membership fee or impose any kind of duties on its members. In short, there are lots of benefits, but no drawbacks to becoming a member. Basically, the Adventurers Guild rewards you every time your adventure rank increases. Here is a new member's gift for you. You will need to return here to claim rewards in the future. Further ado, please allow me to officially welcome you, our new avid adventurer, into the guild. Here is your adventurer handbook. A new member coming aboard is a momentous occasion. A little ceremony is only fair. It has a record of available commissions and rewards, and it is also proof of your membership. Oh, and one more thing. Sometimes you will find yourself stuck at a certain adventure rank. When this happens, you need to perform some impressive feats to gain further recognition from the guild.
Impressive feats? Sounds like hazing to me.
They are simply specific adventures that allow you to ascend to the next adventure rank on completion. Ascension adventures, if you will. But that will come later. Opportunities to win recognition will come as you gain more adventure experience. That will do for today. We will have plenty of chances to meet again in the future. Ad Astra Abyssosk, adventurer. With effort, you shall reach the stars and conquer the abyss.
Yeah. Guess I'll post an expedition at the Adventurers Guild.
Paimon can smell fisherman's toast! The aroma is coming from Good Hunter! A thick slice of soft white toast, topped with a generous serving of onion slices lightly caramelized by the toasting. Yum, yum! Paimon's made up her mind! It's an emergency! We must order ourselves a generous serving of fisherman's toast from Good Hunter, pronto! It's on you, of course.
It's been getting quite busy recently.
This is bad. Such a hassle. Oh, thank the thousand winds. Your arrival must be the grace of the gods. If I may ask, envoy sent by the Animo God to save this mere mortal, could you spare a moment?
Ew, cut it out.
Marvelous. I cannot let my peers hear about this. I cannot seek help from anyone else but you. Please, let us move to somewhere more fit for such conversations. Let's talk in the courtyard just outside headquarters. Come with me.
What's with the sneakiness?
This place will do.
Tell us what it's about already!
How should I begin? Oh, right. Let me tell you a secret first. It's a secret of my past, and I confide in you to keep it.
Don't worry, my lips are sealed.
As a matter of fact, my grandfather was a pirate. Wait, why do you sound so blithe? Do you think I'm making it up? Look at my eye patch. I inherited it from my grandfather, and this is solid proof that we are related by blood. My, how could you not know such common knowledge? This is no different from children inheriting their hairstyles from their parents. Yesterday, I was glancing through the notes my grandfather left and stumbled upon records that spoke of a treasure.
Treasure?
According to his notes, the treasure is buried in the lost Arcadian ruins.
Treasure.
But the location of the ruins is currently unknown. I've tried searching for clues. Treasures that consist of nothing but gold and gems are third-rate treasures. My grandfather's treasure is a sword. A magic sword that grants the wielder unrivaled power.
Oh, wow!
The sword was dropped from Celestia into the sea by a god. It was later salvaged by my grandfather's crew by pure coincidence. The moment he gripped the sword, thunder roared, billows howled, and the clear skies were suddenly swallowed by raging winds. With the might of the magic sword, my grandfather went on to defeat a hydra, a silver-haired banshee, a wicked abyss dragon. But the immense power of the sword enticed many more greedy pirates. To avoid meaningless conflicts, my grandfather hid the magic sword. The world we live in is fascinating, full of unknown and inexplicable wonders.
Holy moly! That's just insane!
A gang of treasure hoarders has been very active lately, and many ruins have had their relics stolen by them. I'm afraid that they will soon discover the Arcadian ruins, and the magic sword will be lost.
We won't let it fall into the wrong hands! We must get the sword before them! You just rest assured that we are here to help!
Wow. Great. Please keep it a secret. I'll wait for your good news.
Hey, so what you think? Isn't it exciting? We're talking about a super duper powerful sword! Well, let's go to the Adventurers Guild and see if we can find out more! The adventurers should know more about the ruins, right?
Doesn't sound very good.
Where am I going to get the moor?
Astra Abyssosk. Welcome to the Adventurers Guild. Add Astra.
Thank you.
It's so delicious! Hum, hum, hum. Good Hunter's Fisherman's Toast is the best! This might surprise you, but it's actually a classic Mondstadt recipe that anyone can cook. You can try cooking it yourself if you have the ingredients. Can your cooking skills surpass that of Good Hunter's? Why, Paima would love to be your personal taster! Don't you let me down!
Looking for you everywhere. How's that wind glider I gave you last time? Seems like it's really growing on you. But then again, you don't have a gliding license, do you?
A gliding license? What's that?
Isn't it obvious? You gotta have a gliding license to legally glide in Mondstadt.
But we've been gliding for ages now. This is the first we've heard about it.
Yeah, you've been gliding all over the place. Everyone's noticed.
So you came looking for us because you want to give us a gliding license?
No way! The Knights of Favonius have strict rules. You need to pass an exam, and only then will the Knights issue your license. Today, I'm here as an examiner to oversee your official gliding exam. I gave you your wing glider, so this is my responsibility. At least that's what Acting Grandmaster Jean would say.
An exam? What a pain in the butt! Then again, since it...
No with a capital N-O! Do not challenge the authority of Examiner Amber! I mean, the whole city saw how well you flew the day that Storm Terror attacked, so I'm sure you'll have no problems! But we do need to respect the rules and glide properly. Here, take this gliding manual. No need to memorize it. Just be familiar with everything in there. For example, only one person per wing glider, no carrying anything over the set weight limit, no taking off using an animo slime, and so on and so forth. Anyway, be sure to read it, okay? I had to read a load of big, thick books too when Lisa was teaching me magic.
Wow, that's a big old book! Paimon thinks we best get started.
Great. Come find me when you're done. I'll be at Windrise.
Knights of Favonia's gliding manual does not sound like a fun read.
When the first wisp of wind brushed across the land, birds that yearned for the sky had wings, but no way to fly. They asked the animal god, "How can we reach the heavens?" To which the animal god replied, "You have yet to find that which is most important." As the god spoke, the wind thrust the seeds of a dandelion high into the sky. The birds thrust out their wings, but the breeze was all too mild, leaving them to stumble across the earth. So they went to the gorge, where the wind showed off its wild and incomparable strength. They threw themselves off the cliff and flapped their wings amongst the howling winds until they were able to fly freely in the sky. To the animal god they went to gleefully say, "We understand now. All we needed was a stronger wind to fly." In reply, the animal god said, "What you lacked was not wind, but courage. It is courage that has allowed you to become the first flying birds of this world."
That's a cool story. But is the Knight's Gliding Manual really written in that style? Huh. Anyway, let's go find Amber.
Freeze!
here. Did you have a good read-through of the gliding manual? Got all the rules down? Sounds like it was a real drag. I would know. I've been there. Ugh, the gliding manual is super dry. I couldn't get into it at all. Don't tell Jean, though.
Really? Paimon thought there were some pretty cool stories in the gliding manual.
Cool stories? Oh, you must mean the example cases in the appendix. Some of them I like. My favorite one is about the illegal animo slime takeoff. Apparently, if you pop an animo slime and take off in the burst of wind, it shoots you up really, really high. I really want to try it.
No, not that story. Paimon meant the one with the little bird who wanted to learn to fly.
What? Let me take a look. Oh, shoot. This is the storybook I used to read as a kid. Oops, sorry. I put both books in the same pile and must have grabbed the wrong one when I was leaving.
How in the heck do you confuse a bedtime story with an instruction manual?
This is so embarrassing. It's because, maybe deep down inside, that fairy tale is the thing that truly taught me how to glide. What you lacked was not wind. It's courage that's allowed you to become the first flying birds of this world. Reading that gave me the courage to glide, to become an outrider, and to become the gliding champion of Mondstadt. But anyway, let's get back to the exam. Don't be nervous. Just glide like you're used to. Okay then, you just need to follow the marked route to the finish. No surprise, given the way you handle your glider in a storm. The next part of the exam is in Mondstadt. See you there. Don't keep me waiting.
Alrighty then. You heard her. Back to the city. Let's not keep her waiting.
The exam. Same deal as before. Glide through the markers and get to the finish without stopping in the middle. The hang of wind gliding now. Let's do the final stage.
Easy! You've flown this way before anyway!
Once you've passed this final stage, you'll finally be able to get your very own gliding license. Just keep thinking about that license. Ready?
Thank you. Windborne Traveler, you are required to land at once by the order of the Knights of Favonius.
I am Otto of the Knights of Favonius.
What's going on?
Please, show me your gliding license. It is against the law to glide without a license. I am arresting you under Section 7, Article 12 of the Mondstadt Penal Code. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say will forever carry on the wind.
Wait, I'm an instructor. This is a gliding exam.
Oh, I see. Well, you picked a bad time to hold your gliding exam.
Really? Why?
The Knights of Favonius received a report from a sister at the cathedral, claiming she saw Raptor gliding around these parts. I thought your student here must have been his partner in crime.
Raptor? Who's that?
A known criminal in Mondstadt. He always uses a wind glider to commit his crimes, so people started calling him Raptor.
Wow, he flies fast then.
So far, we haven't managed to catch him. Our plan this time was to draw him into the cathedral with a precious artifact and ambush him inside. But he escaped with the artifact. Fortunately, one of the sisters put some secret markings on the artifact using elemental magic. But he was too fast, and we couldn't even keep up with the trail the markings left behind.
Well, if you need help chasing down a gliding criminal, I'm the one for the job. So tell me, which way did he go?
As far as I know, he was last seen near Springvale. But that was some time ago.
Leave it to me. With us chasing him down together, he doesn't stand a chance. Once we've got this Raptor guy, we'll pick up where we left off. But no need to worry. I'll be sure to have a word with Jean.
Thank you.
What's the hurry?
Springvale. There must be some clues about Raptor around here. The sister from the cathedral put some secret animal markings on the artifact he took.
Use your elemental sight and keep your eyes peeled for clues.
Broken tree branch.
Oh, Paimon knows! It's from a frame of a wind glider, therefore...
There are no elemental traces on it. It looks like it's just a plain old tree branch.
Strange bird or an animal slime?
Animal slimes are airborne creatures. They don't leave marks on the ground unless someone stomped on one to take off.
How do we know if this was left by raptor or an animal slime?
Either way, let's make a mental note of these markings. They're very clear. A strip of cloth with animal markings on it. Looking at the design and the way it's woven, there's a good chance it came from a wing glider.
Wow, Outriders have to be textile experts now? It's a harder job than Paimon thought.
If this really belongs to Raptor, it must mean his wind glider is broken. It appears that the elemental markings point this way.
Huh. Well, do you think he ran off ahead?
There's only one way to find out. Come on, we should keep following the markings.
Ooh, what's that? Looks like something's going on up ahead.
It sounds like there's a battle going on. Could that be Raptor? Quick, let's keep going.
Thank goodness! The Knights of Favonius have arrived! The hilly trolls won't dare pursue me any longer.
What happened?
I can't believe it, but the hilly trolls attacked our carts! Luckily, I outran them.
Hilly trolls? But I thought the Knights of Favonius had cleared out most of the hilly troll camps around these parts.
It's a small camp not too far from the village. The route I take on my delivery runs ensures I steer clear of it. But today, some crazy fellow suddenly fell out of the sky and landed right in the camp.
Now, who does that remind me of?
It really riled them up. They chased the funny-looking fellow as he fled, which brought them out in the open. I managed to get away, but they smashed my fruit carts to smithereens. I don't know what I'm gonna do when the merchant caravan gets here tomorrow.
Funny looking? In what way?
He was holding on to something. Must have been heavy because he couldn't glide in a straight line to save his life. Maybe that's why he fell. Honestly, people like that shouldn't be allowed in the skies. It doesn't take a genius to know you're not supposed to carry heavy objects while gliding.
Heavy object? The artifact? This could well be our guy. Tell me, did you see which way he went?
I managed to catch a glimpse as I ran from the hilly churls. I think he went that way.
Seems like a strong lead. On with the chase! Oh, and don't worry. As soon as I get back, I'll tell the knights to mop up the rest of the hilly churls as soon as possible.
They've gone. I'd say this lot is with Raptor.
But if that's the case, what are they hanging around here for?
I wonder. Well, this measly bunch can't slow us down, that's for sure. But we also haven't found the artifact, which means Raptor still has it on him. Forget these guys. Come on, let's keep following the elemental markings. Power on the artifact must have worn off. Raptor must have realized the markings would give away his position and sent his minions to slow us down. That way, when the effect wears off, he can make his escape. He won't get away with this. After him!
Thank you.
There's only one way over there. Raptor must be up ahead. However, it looks like the only way we can catch up is if we glide.
But there's a ton of enemies below. They'll definitely attack us after we take off.
If we're gonna do this, we'll have to glide and defeat them in one fell swoop. You still had one stage to go in your exam, right?
Yeah, but what's that gotta do with anything?
How about we make this the third and final stage of your gliding exam?
Are you sure that's how the exam is supposed to go?
It's a custom version of the exam, designed by yours truly. Besides, the normal version of the exam wouldn't be fit for the hero of Mondstadt herself. So, what do you say? Woohoo! Good answer! Prepare for takeoff! Raptor awaits you once you defeat all these enemies. Then that gliding license is yours! Natural. I knew you'd be fine. All that's left now is to grab ourselves a raptor. Let's go!
split.
Ha!
Looks like there's no way across. Ugh, he must be around here somewhere.
Amber! Over there!
If you insist on chasing me, so be it. Huh? Who brought the little girl?
You must be a raptor! You can't escape!
I don't need to escape. There's no way you can make it over here.
Oh, it is pretty high. And quite far.
Oh, little girl, why don't you run along home now and let your leader deal with this? Don't worry, I promise that once the Grandmaster gets here, I'll surrender immediately.
Hey, watch it! You're talking to a Knights of Favonius Outrider! You'll be sorry when I arrest you! You're right. Ugh, he's right there in front of us! If only we could glide across!
So how did he get across? If it's too far to glide, it's definitely too far for anything like that!
There's also no sign of an anchor point!
Bye-bye, kiddo!
Oh no! He's getting away!
Ugh, we can't hesitate any longer! The only way to get across is to glide there!
But...
Don't worry. I'm the gliding champion of Mondstadt, remember? If Raptor can do it, I can do it too!
Oi, Outrider! You have less chance of surviving this than jumping off the Animo God statue in Mondstadt without your wind glider! Ha-ha!
Paimon sees your point. If you rule out everything that's completely impossible, gliding is the only idea left!
Remember that book I lent you? The one I thought was the gliding manual, but wasn't? The first birds couldn't fly. Flight was their reward for their courage to plunge into the canyon. Be my witness. Raptor says I'll never make it. But if you listen carefully...
Wait! Stop! You'll never make it! Come on, off you go now. Back home like a good little girl.
Raptor says I'll never make it. But if you listen carefully... The wind says I will make it, and that's good enough for me.
About the wind current. There's no way you would have jumped otherwise.
There's no wind.
What are you trying to do?
The wind takes care of those who have courage. Now sit still and await your arrest, like a good little boy.
Just you watch.
Freeze!
Have a taste of this! You're open!
Freeze!
From in the air, and it's the only one. It would be suicide to try and escape in the direction Raptor was going. In other words, the only way Raptor could have gotten out would be this way, past us.
Aha! So he was just trying to fool us by acting smug, in the hope that we would just give up and leave. Little did he know, we're not so easily fooled.
It was all thanks to your sharp thinking. Just like a wise man once said, once you eliminate the impossible, whatever remains, no matter how improbable, must be the truth. At the end of the day, gliding is 7 parts technique, 3 parts instinct, and then 90 parts courage.
What you did now looked more like 99 parts courage.
It was just like in my first gliding exam. I was super nervous, but in the end, there was nothing to be afraid of, and I passed no problem. I kinda missed that nervous rush in the exams I've done since then. It just wasn't the same.
Sorry. Paimon thought you said you passed no problem. What do you mean, exams since then?
Well, you see, the thing is, Mondstadt is all, no glide zone this, no landing zone that. Every time I get my license, it keeps getting revoked. I must have taken the exam about 15 times altogether. But I always pass the first time. I guess my little gliding manual ain't so bad after all.
Let's go and get a copy of the real gliding manual from Acting Grandmaster Jean sometime.
I'll head off first, because I need to escort Raptor back to the city. Once you're back in the city, don't forget to come find me at the cathedral. I'll issue your gliding license there.
She just can't sit still, can she? Guess that's why she's the Outrider. When this is all done and dusted, let's head to the cathedral in Mondstadt. Getting this gliding license has turned...
Congratulations! Here is your gliding license. You're officially legal now. Yay! I'm not surprised, though. You are a natural after all. Oh, and I'll sign you up for the next wind gliding championship. I glide so fast that no one can keep up. It's just me up there, on my own, gliding around. It's kinda boring. Whoa, fighting talk. It seems you have no idea how terrifying the championship really is. Well, until I kick your butt in the championship, I wish you a happy, liberating, and above all, law-abiding gliding experience. Make sure you obey the rules. Whatever you do, don't get your license revoked.
Oh, brother. If you ask me, that's a bit rich coming from Amber.
Come take a look. There will definitely be something that catches your eye.
Welcome. Every treasure here is unique. Guaranteed.
Yep. There's nothing here that Paimon recognizes. That's for sure.
What did I tell you? These are all rare items brought back by adventurers from all corners of the world. Is there anything that catches your eye? No need. I forgot to mention, I operate on a trading basis. Goods for goods. No mora accepted here. I've been trying to make something a bit special recently, and I need a lot of animo sigils to decorate it with. Do you have any animo sigils with you? It seems the animal archon approves of your adventures then. More to the point, any animal sigils you find, you can trade in here for items in the shop. Animo sigils appear all over Mondstadt. If you find yourself short, just keep exploring.
Absolutely! What could be more beautiful than a gift from the Animal Archon?
Okay, you got me. It's actually more complicated than that, but it's easier for people to understand if I just say it's for decoration. Obviously, the reason I need animo sigils is because they have properties that other materials cannot provide. Of course. I guarantee you will be quite surprised at the result. Do come again soon, and bring me lots and lots of Animo sigils next time. Please also visit if you come across any weird and wonderful treasures on your adventures. Astro.